Hello and welcome to Cyclistic and Chiseled. We are here for our next round of lower body strength training. For today's workout, you are going to need something that you can glide on. Could be a dish towel, but here I've got a glider found on Amazon that works really well. And you'll need a selection of weights, whether those are dumbbells or kettlebells, totally up to you. We're going to begin with a seated position, some internal rotation. So sit it nice and tall. We're going to take our right knee, tip it in. We're going to go for about 8 of these. The knee does not have to touch the floor. It is going in that direction though, okay? Perfect, we've got 3 more right here. As we're rotating in, try to make sure that that left knee is staying actually pretty still. So just internal rotation on that right side. Switching over now to the left. Perfect. Don't force it, just let it go to where it's going to go. Check in with yourself. How have you slept? I slept 9 hours. I feel like I can still sleep for about 4 more. So I'm still playing a little bit of catch up. What activities did you do over the last couple of days? I did 15 miles 2 days ago, so we'll see how my legs feel for today's workout, you know? And then of course, where are you at in your cycle? And then where are your stress levels at? We're going to come into runner's lunge on that left side. So hands on the inside of that left leg. We're going to keep that right leg lifted. We're going to peel on up, elbow towards the floor. Reach it on up, bring it back down. Excellent. We're going to go for 3 more here. Big twist on down. For 2. 1 more. We'll swap it out. Heel that right arm up. Exhale the elbow down. For 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 2 more. Last one right here. Perfect. Pivoting. We're going to go into Kapalabhati, your version of it, or Skandasana. Up and over to the other side. Ooh, feeling really tight here. Excellent. Opening up those inner thighs. One more each way. Last one right here. So now, we're going to go into the dynamic portion of our workout, I should say of our warm-up as well. We're going to start with 8 kettlebell goblet cleans. We know this skill now. Doesn't have to be your heaviest weight, okay? After those 8 goblet cleans, we're going to put the weight down, we're going to move to the side, we're going to go into 8 squat jumps. We'll do that 2 times through. So starting with those goblet cleans, weight right in between the ankle bones. Lower those hips, chest is up, we clean it. Back to the floor. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Fantastic, 8 squat jumps. 1, 2, 3. Good, 5, 6, 7, woo, 8. Little breather. Sip of water. Second time through. Here we go. should be fun for today's workout. Okay. That being said, let me grab one lighter weight. Just in the off chance that I need it. Okay. First set of strength movements. If you really like your heels elevated, please, by all means, elevate your heels. Regardless, we're in a goblet position. We're going to get to the bottom, pulse, rise up to the top. That's our first movement. We're going to go for about 8 to 10 of those, okay? We then go into a split squat. If you're doing weight, it could be goblet or two weights by your side. Feet start stacked apart. Hope that doesn't make sense. Feet start staggered, okay? From here, we're going to try to rotate towards this front leg and then stand up. Rotating in and stand back up. As you're doing this, still trying to make sure that this knee goes in the same direction as the second toe. We're just really rotating the hips, but trying not to do this with the knee. So keep it in alignment. What this should elicit is a bigger sensation right back here, okay? So you're gonna do 8 of those, okay? And then we're gonna drop one of those weights. We're gonna go into an isometric hold for about 20 seconds. Okay, that'll be a single leg RDL isometric hold. That's our first set of 3 movements. All right, starting with that goblet with the pulse. We clean it, and here we go. To the bottom, and push. For 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, one more, fantastic work, okay, split squat, first side, feet staggered, here we go. Inhale down, exhale push. One more. One weight goes down. 20-second iso hold. Hips nice and square. Oh my goodness, let that burn. You got it. We have 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Whoa. That was a major burn. Switch it up. Other side. Rotating in. Knee stacks right over that second toe though. Here we go. For 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. ISO. Here we go. Good. It's hard. up to. Here we go. Down to the bottom. Good pulse. Nice work. Split squat. Here we go. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
1.
Opposite angle. 12 reps. That's it. trying to keep the core nice and engaged. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, up, six, seven. Pull the core in. Last three, two, one. Awesome. Quick little breather. Two more rounds. Never fails, but I spoil myself. Okay, 10 pivoting lunges. Here we go. For two, three, four, six, seven. Nice work. One more. Really good. Vertical shin, that's the goal here. Okay? It's hard. Here we go. We want hamstrings to be on. For two, three, four, five. Come on. Six. One more. Other side. Vertical shin. For two. Three. Yes, yes, come on. Four. Dead bug. Feet wide. Exhale. Wrap and pull in. Here we go. One. Two. Three. Four. Come on. Five. Six. Eight. Come on. Two more. You're done. One more round. One more. We'll take off in about 15 seconds. What little adjustments can you make for this last round, if any, to show up better for yourself? Here we go. Let's knock it out of the park. Here we go. For three, come on. Four. Five. Two more. It's a good one. It's a really good one. Okay. that dead bug. We're done. Apparently ran time for noise. Here we go. 3, 4, 6. Up, 8, 10. One more. Perfect. Wide-legged forward fold. Bring yourself forward to a point that feels good for you. Excellent work today. There's a take-home message today, so listen to your body, right? Normally I teach in the mornings. This morning my body was like, I just need more sleep. I didn't know that there was a space for me to be able to teach throughout my day. But I really, really like sticking to a plan and my routine. So there's this argument in my head of like, do I just get up and do it? And a reminder that we don't always have to stick to a plan. We can be flexible, or if there's space for us to be flexible, sometimes that's the way to do it, right? I'm now in my luteal phase, so I'm now going to be entering into that phase of like pruning and wanting to be a little bit more isolated, right? Just so much to think about. Just be real with yourself. Meet yourself where you're at. Continue to push yourself, continue to pick up heavy weights, get your heart rate up, all the good things. Just take care of you. Okay? Alright, until next time. See you soon.